disastrous. DVDs are outdated and obsolete, like White Trash Dash. On your marks, get set, white guys, go!
I have high hopes for this. I had a Cliff Bar before we started.
Everybody else!
Phew, I thought they were coming after us.
All right, everyone, all DVDs are a dollar and everything must go. Come on in!
Please be here. Please be here.
Oh, sweet mother of God, there you are!
I'll watch you with the lights off. Like I would dare.
You're getting Dan in real life?
What? I heard it's good.
No, I get it. He's resting his head on pancakes.
It looks hilarious.
The joke, of course, being that one wouldn't generally do that were their pillow available.
Oh my God, Roadhouse! I want to buy this!
Great. And as a bonus, I'll throw in What Dreams May Come with Robin Williams.
No, thank you.
No charge.
I do not want it.
But it's free, sir.
If that DVD even touches Roadhouse, I will kill you.
Don't worry. Someday someone will come and take you home for their very own.
Maybe far away, or maybe real nearby. He may be pouring her coffee. She may be straightening his tie.
My stomach in these jeans, they won't.
Roadhouse.
That was awesome. And its message is timeless.
Peter, the only message in that movie is that every problem in life can be solved by kicking.
Huh? Oh my God. Right. You're right.
Peter, I'm joking.
What did you say to me?
Peter, what are you doing?
Get off my plane.
That's not even the same.
Oh, what the hell? Not gonna talk to me like that in my bar.
Not a bar. Oh.
Oh, that's right. Cleveland moved.
Here's your burger, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, I need another $1.25.
Is that right? Keep the change. Roadhouse. Okay, that is the last time you are gonna pull that crap. You hear me?
Yes.
Do you hear me?
Yes.
You are gonna hold down that football until Charlie Brown kicks it. You got that?
Yes.
Go ahead, Charlie. And you know what else? I did some checking around. You're not a licensed therapist. Roadhouse.
You know, it's still early, Peter. What do you say we horse around a little, huh?
I think I can get on board with that.
Ow!
Roadhouse.
Peter, for God's sakes, if you're gonna do that, at least aim for my breasts.
Roadhouse.
Peter, I don't think you should be driving with your feet.
Roadhouse.
Wait, why are you taking the back way home? There are so many turns.
Roadhouse. 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 Roadhouse.
Oh my God! Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Sorry. I wasn't really looking where I was going.
Probably a little blame on our side, too.
Roadhouse?
Well, I guess we're just lucky nobody got hurt.
Yeah, I agree. But, you know, I sort of have one other problem. Maybe you can help me out.
What's that?
I have a dinner reservation for two tonight at Dominic's, and it's just me.
I see your problem. I think I might be able to help.
Man, you want me to kick those debts out for you?
Peter, we've had complaints from all over town. You're gonna have to stop with the kicking.
Oh, yeah? I think my scary, otherworldly, shadowy spirit friends might have something to say about that. Ghost.
It's the easiest because it's the cheesiest. Kraft for the win-win.
Can I help you?
Hi, I'm Brian. I'm here to pick up Nicole.
Oh, hi, I'm Rita, her mom. You must be the one she had that fender bender with.
Well, I got to meet Nicole, so I prefer to think of it as a happy accident. Is she ready?
Oh, well, unfortunately, she left for dinner with another guy about half an hour ago.
What? We had a date.
Yeah, I'm afraid that's Nicole. She's 21 and gorgeous. Guys ask her out all the time, and I think she loses track.
Oh, for God's sake. Well, let me at least leave my car insurance information for her.
Is that your condom?
No, I wasn't going to use that on your daughter. I mean, I would not use a condom on your daughter. I mean, I would if I was having sex with her, which obviously I would not do. But if I'm safe and all, you know, I get an AIDS test once every 3 months. And not because it's not because I have a lot of sex. I just eat a lot of poo off the street. Think of it, how did this get in my wallet in the first place?
Dear Brian, somewhere between the point when you're excited enough to want it and too excited to care, think about your future, your friends, Dewey.
Well, I think I've been humiliated enough for one evening. Sorry to bother you.
If it's any consolation, I would never stood you up.
Well, I guess that makes you one of the rare ones nowadays. Your husband's a lucky guy.
Divorced?
Oh. Risk of humiliating myself once again, I still have a reservation.
Well, I don't have plans.
Well, terrific. Hey, maybe I'll get to use this after all, huh? I'm kidding.
Oh, please, at my age, I don't have to worry about pregnancy.
How old are you?
Oh, you don't want to know.
I kind of do.
Hang on, just let me get my purse and we can go.
Wow, she seems great. We're getting along better than Whitney Houston and Bobby Brown.
You want some crack?
I love you.
Get the crack!
Brian, you want some lasagna?
Oh, no thanks. Rita and I grabbed a bite already.
Gosh, you've been seeing this Rita for weeks now, and you still haven't brought her over to the house. When are we gonna meet the lovely lady, huh?
Oh, she's being ironic. What are you saying? I don't date lovely women? Yeah, you got it, you got it.
No, it just seems like some of your past girlfriends have been a little dumb and trampy.
First of all, that's not true. And second of all, she's not like that. She's wonderful, she's smart, she's pretty. And, you know, the only reason I haven't brought her around is that you guys don't always make the best impression with girls I date, especially Peter.
Hey, aren't you that chick from the bathroom door?
Come on, Peter, she doesn't want to talk about work.
What's it like in there?
I assume it's like how it is in the men's room.
Oh, there's a long trough with a big poo in it?